Hello, dear ones. It's Alice. I'm of the stars. And I had an interesting revelation at church today, which I'll try to explain. When people are rising to consciousness and becoming aware of the repressed thought forms, the emotion-laden thought forms, generally negative ones, in their gut brains, and you as an ascensioneer or light worker are observing the clair chatter in their subconscious minds, the first thing that you'll notice is a lot of neg speak. And I've published a separate blog explaining a way to deal with that neg speak that transforms it from the negative to the positive. And so, so you as an observer of the subconscious mind of other people and the unconscious thought cloud of the world can step aside in neutral mind and observe all that. Now, I'd like to talk a little about how people speak together subconsciously before they rise to awareness of their gut brains. You may find individual people, generally solitary people, people who live solitarily, who live alone, or are celibate, like that, talking to you, sending thought forms to you on the astral plane in response to your own subconscious meanderings and emotional, especially emotion-laden feelings. Thought forms, in addition, meander around through the unconscious thought cloud of the world, just looking for a similar vibration or a similar energy thread to combine with. And sometimes these stray thoughts of people that have no specific like direction or person that they're being aimed at will arrive at your door in response simply to an emotion that you're feeling. So that there are the thoughts of solitary people that are presented to you as one-on-one in response to a subconscious thought form that you've broadcast unawares. There are also wandering thought forms that have no home that find their way to you simply because there's a resonance there. And these two can be dealt with pretty easily using the technique, sidestepping technique, I've mentioned in another blog. Now, with regard to groups of people who are still strongly tied into the subconsciousness of the gut brain and haven't started the process of becoming aware of their subconscious tendencies, their samskaras and so forth, and clearing their natal tendencies and clearing their morphogenetic fields, as some say, their karmic, miasmic distortions of the light. There are a lot of names for that, but those are the things that are responsible for the sounds that we hear in the subconscious plane, I think. A lot of people agree to that in many different faiths and philosophical traditions. Anyway, people who are bound together through the gut brain, and this generally happens because they're having sex together. Before they rise to consciousness, their subconscious minds, their gut brains, actually carry on conversations together that you might think were conscious conversations, and even think that were conspiracies against you or plans against you. And this is because it's primarily neg speak and negative opinions that are not socially acceptable, that don't live up to societal expectations, that are being bound down and repressed in the gut brain as part of the inner child that's not allowed to speak, that isn't allowed a voice in the world after the age of reason is attained. So our job is to give that child a chance to speak, to say all of her upsets or his upsets, to say all of his hopes and expectations that have not been met, and to just allow that child into our own grown-up heart so that we can become one from a lower mental body to the higher mental body. That's our hope. And of course, the other hope is to unite the left and right hemispheres of the brain and then have a unified higher mental body. And still greater hope is through the soul, through the soul's wisdom, to unite all of the intelligences of all of our bodies, both subtle and physical, so that we can act as one person with one soul and through the soul's learning. So all the people on earth are rising up to this call of soul wisdom and soul learning and unconditional love right now, right? But there's this like turmoil and maelstrom going on, and it has to do with the fact that people are sleeping together. If the people that are sleeping together are a married couple that have been together for a long time and feel love towards each other, it's pretty easy to deal with their repressed thoughts. Even if they have a negative thought. Like in church today, there was someone in front of me, away from me, who was doing the Iwo Jima thing, only a much modified version of it. He was he kept having repetitive, repressed thoughts. One of them had to do with, will you have sex with me? Will you have sex with me? And that had to do with his inner child not being satisfied with regard to sexual joy, you see. Maybe he had been working too hard. You know, most likely he just overlooked that he really needed to take care of that situation and please himself, please his body cells and himself. And so over and over again, this like unfulfilled desire came up and popped out of his higher brain, the right side of his brain, and slammed into my brain. You know, over and over again, it was like giant popcorn, pachoo, pachoo, pachoo. Because I'd already had some experience with the Iwo Jima thing, I was ready, you know, and I almost immediately placed the thought forms to this one person that was some ways in front of me. So then I started employing the technique that's called sidestepping technique that's in the other blog. And that was working, you know, not too well after a while because he started to fall asleep he started to become semi-somnambulant during the talk. But before that, I had some success. Let's see, what was he talking about subconsciously? Yes, I recall at first he was saying, don't look at me, don't look at my back. Don't think about me, don't look at me, like that over and over again, because he felt, I guess, self-conscious about being in front of a woman, I guess. So I was using a sidestepping technique with that pretty well, and then the other topic came up. So in the meantime, a couple arrived, actually a woman and her child sat down beside me. And subconsciously or consciously, they heard the commotion that was going on with regard to the man far in front of me. And they got up and left, and a couple came and sat down beside me. So the couple had in mind, maybe there was devilish stuff going on. This was in their subconscious minds. Maybe then they would take care of it. They'd make sure there was none of that in their church, right? But because they had this foundation of love between them, as a couple, I was able to talk to them consciously, and they were much more conscious of what was going on in their gut brain. So that was easy to deal with, basically. It was very easy. And I arrived at some very fruitful insights and conclusions because of the talk that we had together. Now, there's one other type of situation that I want to talk to you about that's much more difficult to deal with. That is the situation of polyamory, when there are people in a group who are all making love together, who are, for instance, say six people in a group or eight people in a group who are perhaps couples, married couples who are swinging with other married couples, or it might be just a group of single people, say 12 single people who are all exchanging sexual favors amongst themselves. Let me think. Or it might be in a group situation where everyone in the group sleeps with everyone else in the group, or maybe only with the leader. These situations present to the light worker or ascensioneer in a much different and much more threatening manner. Basically, what's happening is that all of the people in the polyamorous grouping talk together subconsciously, and you can hear them. As a clairperson, you can hear them talking, and it seems like they're doing a conspiracy thing against you. They're doing an in-group thing, and that involves war on outsiders, war on out-groups. And you represent the out-group, right? Because you're not sleeping with them. And so it can, at this stage of the ascension process, that in-group, out-group like thing, or warring on out-groups, can result in physical danger to the ascensioneer, or even mortal peril. So you'll hear, what you'll hear is, especially when you fall asleep and are in, hopefully in a lucid dreaming state, or are doing yoga nidra, which is a very important skill to learn right now. So you're sleeping and you're aware of what's going on at the same time, then you will find out, or if you're just waking up from a deep sleep, you can notice what is happening in the minds of these other polyamorous groups with regard to you. And after that, you can fashion a way to deal with that situation. I'll have more on this in the future. I just like to put out there that that's the cause of this problem. The cause of this problem is polyamory. That's the cause of the danger to light workers right now, in-group, out-group thing. And it happens in Christian churches, between Christian churches as well, because of creeds and beliefs. But the most dangerous situation has to do with shared sexual intercourse amongst groups, because that gathers and garners the subconscious minds and the gut brains of a bunch of people together, and they talk and plot together as if they are in a like a sentient group. And typically, as these semi-somnambulant groups of polyamorous people begin to rise to consciousness, there will be one person, maybe the person perceived as the most powerful, as the leader, for reasons of fame or power, who attains an acting out point with regard to the ascensioneer or light worker, and who signals, generally through an email or a phone call, signals the other members of the polyamorous group to act in some way against the light worker or ascensioneer. And that is just a middling step that's happening, an acting out where everybody in the group thinks that's what they're supposed to do because the person perceived as the leader told them to do it. They're rising to consciousness faster than he actually, because they're in a defensive position. He's the leader, right? And so he comes up with something that he doesn't really know the full intent of what he's doing. He's half sleepwalking too, and that's a danger zone. Then there comes a point after that, if you survive as a light worker, there comes a point, if you're nimble on your feet and if you know what to do, if you know where to go and what to avoid, if you stop talking to them, for instance, altogether and turn to another group, then there'll come a point at which they all become conscious enough to know not to act out anymore. And that's something to look forward to. For those of you Ascensioneers and light workers who are united in marriage with someone, I believe it would probably be less of a problem if it's a happy marriage. However, I have noticed that many of the light workers who are happily married are experiencing marital difficulties right now because there's a certain amount of the glom effect involved in marital bonding. And so it's a little more difficult than it would be for a celibate person to achieve complete soul clearing. So that's all for now. Y'all take care. Love y'all lots. Have a wonderful solstice celebration in this June of 2017.